It's proper James Bond, isn't it?
Four sets of holiday hosts.
Oh, wow, it's tiny, isn't it?
It is.
Check into each other's places.
Hello, Jane. How's Sharon?
Nice. Hello, Stephen.
And check out one another.
I'm a chef, so for me, the breakfast component of the stay is always the most important.
Definitely raises the pressure for breakfast tomorrow.
That's exactly what I thought.
Today, there are ghostly goings-on.
Does anybody have extra sensory perception?
Yeah. Oh, no!
As they battle...
You will need to bring your wellies and a Mac that doesn't mind if it gets a bit clarty.
Clarty?
Stephen did give us some tasters, and I wish I hadn't have asked now.
..to be named best value for money.
I'm disappointed with that.
The second visit of the week is to Sproatley near Hull and Burton Constable Holiday Park, run by wardens Gemma and Mark Heron, who aren't scared of adventure.
When we met, literally a few months later, we were travelling around India for 6 months. Mark bought a motorbike in Madras. I was pillion on the motorbike for 6 months, and then at the end of it, I flew home and Mark rode home.
Pulled up outside.
Beep, beep.
Brum, brum.
And just moved in.
Those also looking to rev their engines will find 9 glamping pods and 13 lodges for up to £175 a night, based on a 3-night minimum stay. A cooked brekkie is available for an additional cost from the on-site store. And for this place, it's all about the location.
The unique thing about Burton Constable is the heritage. So we're really closely linked with Burton Constable Hall. It's a beautiful Elizabethan building. So we've got this beautiful landscape, a beautiful hall, and then right next to it, our extraordinary holiday park.
And it may not be their names on the deeds, but this pair are passionate about the place.
We're the park wardens. Mark and I greet all the guests when they arrive and then make sure everything's good for their stay. We don't own the park, but I think the value for money for our accommodations is fantastic. We want to win 100%.
About to arrive are today's first guests.
Where do you think those geese are flying to, Jane? Is it true that it's set they go south?
Yeah, absolutely. They're off for some warmer weather, I think.
Let's all fly south then.
Spreading their wings are Jane Harris and friend Sharon Dickinson from Plasmainen Country House in Conwy, North Wales. Over drinks on the last visit, Gemma and Mark gave them a picture of their place.
It's going to be very different. Very different to a town, very different to a Georgian house.
But we'll look after you.
I don't want to assume anything. Could be.
Well, I'm getting quite scared.
So today, Jane and Sharon are worried about pitching in.
I'm getting a feeling of shepherd hut. I'm getting a feeling of yurt. I think that it could be a wigwam.
I reckon we're going to be braving the elements tonight, Jane. Brave.
Hey, we might not even have a tent. We might be under the stars.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my God. No.
Oh, wow.
5-star holiday park.
Oh, wow.
That is absolutely stunning.
Hi.
Hello. Hello.
How are you?
Good morning again.
Welcome to Burton Constable Holiday Park. You're staying in our 2-bedroom lodge. It's £175 per night based on a 3-night minimum stay. And breakfast is available at an additional cost. So hop back in your car and follow us.
Thank you.
Oh, wow, this is immaculate.
It's gorgeous, isn't it?
Oh, wow. This is stunning, isn't it?
I can't wait to sit down and relax here.
No doubt with a glass of Prosecco,
no
Jane.
No doubt.
As Jane and Sharon get set for a sparkling stay, the next guests are raring for their road trip.
Well, Jess,
I'm excited.
I'm excited as well. I'm looking forward to seeing where we're going.
It's a bit like a murder mystery type thing, isn't it?
Yeah, hopefully nobody gets murdered.
Coming in cloak and dagger are Claire Moseley and daughter-in-law Jessica Waggett from Derwent House Apartments in Scarborough, North Yorkshire. When they hosted last time...
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
All guests were beachy keen.
Oh, my God. Wow. Yeah. I'm well impressed.
Great-looking kitchen for self-catering. It's got everything you need.
It is spotless.
And when it came to the big question...
Would you stay here again?
It was a unanimous, I do like to be beside the seaside.
Yes, fantastic.
Yes, 3 out of 3, get in.
Today, they're still riding the wave of their success.
I think we probably have set the bar quite high, just based on the scores we've got back.
I feel genuinely excited now as well, that we can really enjoy the rest of the experience being hosted by the other three.
Soak it up.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. Welcome to Burton Constable Holiday Park. You're staying in a two-bedroom lodge. Ooh. It's £175 per night.
Lovely. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ooh.
Oh, it's very smart, isn't it?
Definitely. For a lodge, this is really, really quite classy, isn't it?
While Claire and Jess digest the decor, the final guest is cruising along.
I'm looking forward to seeing all of them again. The group seems to be really getting on with itself, and I'm actually really quite excited and looking forward to seeing what Mark and Gemma have got.
Puffed up with positivity is Stephen Myers from the Crossings Inn in Rowelltown near Carlisle, Cumbria, who's a fan of a down-to-earth stay.
I've stayed in a lot of five-star hotels. They're fantastic for what they are. They're just not me. And the ethos of this pub is we're not expensive, we're no frills. We are what we are. When I go away, I tend to look for places similar to what I do. Hi, Mark.
Hi, Stephen. Welcome to Burton Constable Holiday Park. You're staying in one of our two-bedroom lodges. The price is £173.33 per night. So, please, jump back in your car and follow us.
A nice modern kitchen, really luxurious looking lounge. Quite impressed so far.
With the hosts out of the way, it's time to see if Burton Constable Holiday Park hits the mark.
It's so immaculate.
So well looked after.
It's a well-equipped kitchen. Ah, oh, there's the cutlery drawer. Everything seems to be in place.
Oh, that is comfy.
Oh, God. Sleep on here, Jeff.
Yeah, that is comfy.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, it's gorgeous.
I love the way they've followed through with the colour.
It's a bit warm in here, so I'm going to open the door, get a bit of fresh air in. Get a bit... Oh, that's better.
A nice stool where I can sit and do my makeup and hair with a plug point and everything.
Look, an ironing board.
Definitely everything you need for a self-catering family holiday.
Shower looks nice. Loo's lovely and clean. The elbow just touches quite a hot radiator, actually.
This all looks brand new, but there's, like, rust on there.
Or is it coffee or something?
That's not coffee.
I don't want to lick it to test it.
Oh, is this my bed?
It certainly is.
I love it.
Overlooks lovely and clean. And new, so it's not just new and clean, it's clean, clean.
Oh, there's a nice fly here, Claire. Should we get it out? Oh, there's three flies.
Room inspection's almost over. Stephen's counting the cost.
Roughly speaking, it works out about £90 per room, per night, excluding breakfast. It's definitely high-end for what you've got here, I think.
Jane's found a furry friend.
I just love this rabbit.
Cuddle that tonight.
I'm going to cuddle him tonight with my big pillows.
And Claire and Jessica jump for joy.
Oh, very comfy.
Bounce check passed.
Burton Constable Holiday Park is nestled in 200 acres of natural parkland, designed by renowned landscape architect Capability Brown. And today, Gemma and Mark are taking their guests to the jewel in its crown.
Welcome to Burton Constable Hall. Today, you're going to get a private tour from the last person that was actually brought up in this hall, Rodrika.
Wow.
Let's go.
Thank you.
I'm really excited.
Yeah, we like a little bit of history, don't we?
Yeah.
Absolutely our cup of tea, isn't it, sweetie darling?
Absolutely.
As they head inside...
Oh, hello, welcome.
Constable family member Rodrika gets the tour underway.
The Constable family has been on this site since the 1100s, but the first main house was built in 1570 in the Elizabethan style, which is absolutely beautiful. We're in the staircase hall at the moment, which is a magnificent room. I grew up here, and so it's a very special place for me. My earliest memory is of this room when I was part of a hide-and-seek game at the age of 4.
First stop is to see a treasure of one of the hall's most ostentatious ancestors.
Lady Rosina was a queen of bling, and she wanted a grand piano to end all grand pianos, and she had it blinged to the hilt to £100,000, near enough.
Wow.
Wow.
But you can never have too much bling.
I thought that was really funny what Sharon said about the bling. Totally in character. I think Sharon would do bling, definitely.
Next, It's up the elaborate staircase and into the royal bedchamber.
Welcome to the gold bedroom.
The scene of some ghostly goings-on.
Wow. Ooh, love. Oh, my God.
Beautiful.
My father's mother was determined that she would see a ghost, so she decided she was going to stay in here, and she said, I want to be on my own. And the next morning, she said, when I woke in the middle of the night, there was a gentleman standing at the end of my bed, and he said, I've just come to see what you are doing to my house. And then he went away, so he must have been happy.
There's something quite nice about that story. I think, you know, it's quite romantically nice.
Does anybody have extra sensory perception? Can you feel it?
Oh, no. I actually do feel a little bit like, you know, my hairs are standing on end a bit. Like, there maybe is a prison.
Jen and Sharon are a bit of a mystery still to us, aren't they?
She's saying she can sense ghosts. Not sure, unless she's got business in, like, crystals and healing and tarot cards or something. I don't know.
I did feel the hairs on my arms go a little bit, you know, standy up here, and I felt a little bit of a chill.
Tour over, the guests get to have a nose around alone.
There's little birds on the top.
Oh yes, I can see them now.
Look at the detail in these gloves.
Yeah, do you reckon they're silk?
Do I like wearing silk?
I don't know, Stephen.
No, they wouldn't fit.
And as the afternoon draws to a close, the hosts hope their historic trip has hit the spot.
I think everyone really enjoyed this house, and I think it has made a really good impression on them all. So hopefully that's good for us.
I think Gemma and Mark have been brilliant hosts so far.
Yeah.
They've been really welcoming. I'm looking forward to drinks and seeing what more things will be revealed about
them. Yeah.
The second visit of the week is to Sproatley near Hull, where hosts Gemma and Mark have taken their guests down to the local for a swift pint.
Cheers, everyone.
Cheers, everyone.
Cheers.
Drinks chinked, Claire's keen to probe the couple on their past.
I just wanted to know where you two met.
In a pub.
Oh.
I was a barmaid and Mark was a drinker.
Thought I might get some free pints out of it. Didn't work.
After we'd known each other for a year or so, we went travelling together in India.
Riding motorcycles across the Himalayas.
Wow.
And then we was thinking, how can we keep this momentum going, travelling and that?
So we worked together on the holiday parks all over Europe. And then this year we made the decision that we would come back to the UK.
So do you both love travelling then,
yeah.
I take it? Like a passion?
Yeah, and that's the greatest thing that we've been able to do these past 11 years is because we've worked a season every year, we've still had enough time each winter to go off and do something exciting that we really want to do.
Had some great adventures together.
Yeah.
Oh, good for you. Yeah. That's lovely.
To work together, play together and travel together for as long as they have just means that they have found the person they should be with for the rest of their lives. Amazing. Did you get married in the UK?
We did get married in the UK, but then we went on like the longest honeymoon ever.
Oh, come.
So who popped the question then?
Me.
Oh. Is it a leap year?
I don't know.
Well, obviously, yes.
Clearly. Yeah.
Tonight, Gemma told us that she proposed to Mark, which is interesting but not surprising because she definitely has the more gregarious character and she's probably the more outgoing of the two.
It's a very strong feminist action to ask someone to marry you as a woman. So
yeah.
I like that.
We're all good.
About
yeah,
her.
Massively supportive.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's a great thing.
Hosts history explored. Sharon's hungry for a taste of the future.
Stephen, you're a chef. And I believe that we're at your place next.
Ooh.
So what can we expect from you?
You will need to bring your wellies.
Oh.
What?
Ooh. And a Mac that doesn't mind if it gets a bit clarty.
Clarty?
It's a local word which will give you a bit of a clue as to where we might be.
Like covered in mud?
Amongst other things.
Blumineck.
I'm scared. Stephen did give us some tasters and I wish I hadn't have asked now because he said we were going to get a bit clarty. I don't know whether I fancy this, really, but hey-ho, I'll give it a go.
I've never heard that phrase before. I think it means getting dirty in some way or a form.
Muddy.
But do you know what? I think that sounds ace. I'm really looking forward
Me
to
too.
It.
Drinks done. It's all back to the holiday park for bed, where Jane is having trouble getting snug.
I've been trying to get the central heating on. It's pretty cold. I've had a go with all the buttons, and there are no instructions.
I'm definitely looking forward to a good night's sleep tonight.
I think we'll get it here. It's nice and quiet.
See you in the morning.
See you in the morning.
It's a new day in Sprokely, where the guests are rising and shining.
I slept really well.
Did you?
Sleep well?
I did. Really well. Bed was really comfy.
Yeah,
nice and warm. Peaceful.
Morning, Jane.
Morning.
How did you sleep?
I slept really well, actually, with all my pillows.
Yeah,
I slept well.
Guests at the holiday park can opt to self-cater or, for an additional cost, have brekkie cooked for them at the on-site store, where Gemma and Mark are confident in their offering.
I think the breakfast menu's good. They can have a full English or they can have something a bit lighter if they want. It comes with a drink, so they can have a coffee or a tea to go with it. Oh, we'll just see how it goes.
And so it's time to phone in the orders.
I'd like a full English, please.
One full English breakfast, please.
The only thing I don't like is mushrooms, please.
Could you do cheese on top of the beans on toast?
That'll do me spot on.
That was easy, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Plates picked, the chef gets cooking. And while Stephen has opted to dine al fresco at the store...
Lovely, thank you.
Gemma and Mark are off on their delivery round with the other brekkies.
So you ordered breakfast.
Thank you.
You are. Enjoy.
Just bought brekkie.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
This looks nice, Jess. It was a real pleasant surprise to see Gemma and Mark this morning,
wasn't it? It was lovely.
Really didn't expect that. Mm.
And with the food delivered...
Oh, wow.
Oh.
It's very well presented, isn't it? That looks really nice.
Yeah.
It's time to tuck in.
Mm.
Mm. Good choice.
Quality sausage.
It is actually.
It is a quality sausage, yeah.
Sausage is nice. Bacon's nice and thick, which is nice. It's very good.
Mmm, that's nice. How's your cheesy beans?
Very good.
Nothing like having somebody make a sausage sandwich for you, is there, when you're away? I don't think I'd be using the oven anytime soon here, do you?
No, you do too much of that at home. When you go away, you just want them treats, don't you?
Yep. This is a treat.
It is a treat.
The sausage sandwich was spot on for me this morning. Bit of tomato sauce. Happy days.
The breakfast in itself was very good. Full English breakfast minus the mushrooms. I had an extra egg instead. The fact they had plum tin tomatoes, I do like it because it makes the toast get all soggy in there. It's really nice.
Brekkie polished off. Talk turns to the next host's offering.
I'm a bit scared.
What of the clarty?
The clarty. Bring your wellies and what else did you tell you to bring? Mac. I've got a feeling we're going to be doing something like milking cows.
I'm with you on that. Milking cows, you just don't know, do you?
Predictions pondered. It's time for the guests to fill out their anonymous feedback forms.
How were your hosts at Burton Constable Holiday Park?
I think Mark and Gemma were perfect hosts.
They've got a great working relationship.
Oh, got to be a 10.
10.
Friendly.
And?
Accommodating.
I would say so. So a 10?
Yeah, definite 10.
How clean was Burton Constable Holiday Park? Well, all I can say about that is that everything about it has been spotless. So for me, that's a 10.
Well, there was the rust on the hinge in the cupboard in the kitchen. Yeah.
And the flies in the living room.
Yeah. An 8?
Yeah.
How were the facilities?
Well, the kitchen equipment was great. The chalet was slightly overheated on arrival, and the radiator and bathroom very hot. So I'm just going to mark that down as a 9.
The issue with heating.
So, heating manual.
I think about an 8.
An 8.
How did you sleep?
Oh, so well. Good temperature.
Peaceful surroundings?
Yeah.
10.
Yeah, it's a 10.
I slept like a log.
I second that. Should we say 10?
Yeah, definitely.
So how was breakfast? The breakfast was very good. That can only be a 10.
So now for the big question, Jess.
Mm-hmm. Would you stay here again?
Do you know, I think I would, yes.
Yes.
So I think we're going to say yes.
For a family, great. But for two people, it's a little bit overpriced for the size of what you've got. For me, that's a no.
Now the guests must pay what they think their stay was worth.
We decided?
Yes, I think we have.
The cash will be kept secret until the end of the competition. But for now, Gemma and Mark can find out if their guests had an arresting stay at Burton Constable.
How were your hosts at Burton Constable Holiday Park?
10. Yeah. Fantastic.
Phew. Good start.
Perfect hosts.
Oh, that's good.
That's really nice. Yeah. Great working relationship. Yeah, we like working together, don't we?
Yeah.
How were the facilities?
An 8.
I'm pretty happy with that, yeah. Heating manual. They obviously couldn't figure out the heating.
Yeah.
Yeah, fair enough. That's something we could look at putting in.
How did you sleep?
10. Excellent.
Slept like a log.
Oh,
that's brilliant.
Yeah.
Yeah, good. Yeah. I'm glad they had a good night's sleep.
Thank you. Thank you.
Bye.
Right then, big question.
Here we go.
Would you stay here again? Yes.
Fantastic.
Brilliant.
Yeah. Ready?
No. How were your hosts at Burton Constable Holiday Park? A 10.
Yeah. Friendly. Accommodating.
Brilliant.
Really good.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
How clean was Burton Constable Holiday Park? An 8.
Okay.
It's not a bad score,
no,
is
it's
it?
Not,
there's
no.
clearly something that yeah. wasn't right.
Rust on hinge.
Honestly, a bit of rust on a hinge wouldn't particularly bother me.
Well, it's a maintenance thing, yeah. really, that could need looking at.
Flies. Fair enough. I wouldn't yeah. like it if there was flies.
No. How did you sleep?
10.
Yeah.
Good temperature. Peaceful surroundings. Yeah, it is a really yeah. peaceful place to sleep.
Bye.
Bye.
See you later. Bye.
Would you stay here again?
Yes.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Brilliant.
Okay.
Right.
How clean was Burton Constable Holiday Park?
A 10.
Spotless.
Spotless. That's brilliant.
Really good.
I'm really happy with that.
Yeah. How were the facilities?
9.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good score. Great kitchen.
Good. Maybe this is Stephen. Might be his first thing that he looks at when he goes somewhere.
Chalet slightly overwarm on arrival. I think we were really conscious that we didn't want them to be too cold on arrival, so we probably overcompensated. Radiator in bathroom, very hot.
Good for drying your towels, though.
Yeah.
But yeah, that needs turning down.
How was breakfast? 10.
Breakfast very good at the Woodland Store. That's... really pleased with that. Yeah.
Okay, then. Bye-bye. Bye.
We've had 2 yeses. Are we going to get a third?
There's only one way to find out.
No. I'm disappointed with that because all the comments were really,
really good,
and really
yeah.
positive, so just not
this
for
thing,
them.
Yeah.
Really good comments yeah. from all 3 of them, and high scores all the way through.
Yeah.
I have no idea how this makes us stand in the competition.
I think
we're just going to have to wait and see.
Yeah.
Next time, when it's Stephen's turn to host...
Hello.
Hi, Gemma. Hi, Mark.
There's Animal Attraction.
He's very relaxed, actually,
he
isn't
is.
He, now?
How many ewes will he actually mate with?
Between 40 and 80.
How many?
Oh, wow.
And full-on feedback.
I feel quite emotional. I'm a little bit overwhelmed.